This video is proudly brought to you by Hovertech. Hovertech. Just a button away.
In this video tutorial, I'll be explaining how to flash the firmware to a Mediatek Android phone using Miracle Box. The things you need for this guide are your firmware, of course, the firmware for the phone model you wish to flash in the .bin format. You need Miracle Box too, and you need your Mediatek VCOM drivers. Now, the drivers are to ensure that your PC can communicate with the phone effectively for flashing to occur. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is to install your Mediatek VCOM drivers. We already have several guides on that at the Hovertech forum and at our YouTube channel, but I'll just briefly take you through that so you have a clear idea of how the whole thing is supposed to work. Alright, so the first thing you want to do is to launch your device manager by pressing the window button, device manager. Now I'm using a Windows 10 PC, so that means I first had to disable my signature verification. So if you're using a Windows 8 or 10 PC, you need to disable your driver signature verification so you can install unsigned drivers, okay? Because this Mediatek VCOM driver is an unsigned driver. So ensure you see our video and our guide on how to disable signature verification on a Windows 8 or 10 PC. Alright, so with my signature verification disabled, the first thing you want to do is to launch device manager as I've done. Let me drag this down here. Alright, so you'd want to click any item here, just select any item on the list at all. Then you click on action, add legacy hardware, next, install the hardware that I manually select from a list, next, next. Have disk, click on browse. Now you need to navigate to the directory where you have your VCOM drivers. This is it here, then drivers USB VCOM. Now you need to know your PC's architecture, if yours is 32 or 64 bits. And as you can see on the list, we have just Windows 7 as the latest. So if you are using a Windows 7, 8 or 10 PC, you have to select the Windows 7 folder for the driver installation. Okay, so for you to know if your PC is 32 or 64 bits, just quickly go to my computer, right-click properties, then you have that. Mine is 64-bit PC. Alright, so I'm going to select the one for 64 bits. Okay, so I'll put Windows 7. This is a Windows 10 PC, so I need to select the Windows 7 folder for the driver installation. So this one is the one for 32 bits, this for 64 bits, so I just select 64 bits since mine is 64 bit PC. Then I click on open and then I click on OK. Alright, so at this point you click on next. You can see this warning, the driver is not digitally signed. You just click on next. You can ignore that, provided you've disabled your signature verification, you shouldn't have an issue with that. Okay, next again. Or for Windows 7 users, you don't have to disable that. That is disabled by default. So just for Windows 8 and 10 users. Okay, so it says the following hardware was installed. I have my Mediatek USB VCOM port, and I have this. The device cannot start code 10. It's nothing to worry about. The only reason why you're getting that error is because you have installed an unsigned driver, alright? So it's nothing to worry about. It doesn't mean it's not going to work. It's just an unsigned driver. And you might have this yellow sign there. You don't need to worry about it. It just means you have installed an unsigned driver. That is what basically this means. Alright? So it's going to work. Alright, at this point I've installed VCOM drivers. The next thing you want to do is to launch your Miracle Box. I double click mine. So you have to wait a little for Miracle Box to launch to the dashboard. Now at this point, just to save time, okay, it is up. Now, the next thing you want to do here is to click on empty key. Since we are flashing a MediaTek Android phone, click on empty key, then you tick right. Now, from this place, I have to select the firmware for your phone model. Alright, so sorry, you have to select the chipset. I mean, so you have to know your phone's chipset. Mine is an MT6580 phone, so I will just select this option. Alright, so after selecting the chipset, the next thing you want to do is to click this folder icon so you can select the firmware you wish to flash, which is in .bin format. So this is my 6580 phone. I select it from the list and I click on open. Alright, so we are good to go. Now at this point, you click the start button and the miracle box should start standing by for you to connect the phone. Now what you need to do at this point now is to switch off the phone and make sure the battery is inside the phone. All right, switch off the phone with a charged battery in the phone. Now with my phone switched off and the battery inside, I'll connect it to the PC via a USB cord, and then you need to hold on for flashing to begin. Okay, it has recognized the phone and then it's going to start flashing. So you need to be very patient because it could take a while for this flashing procedure to be completed. So ensure not to interrupt the flashing process. So it's at 1% now, you'd have to wait till it gets to 100%. Now when it gets to 100%, you close the miracle box and you disconnect the phone, then you boot up the phone. And if the phone is still somehow stuck at maybe a boot loop or boot animation, just boot into recovery mode and you do a factory reset, then boot up the phone. So that is basically how to flash a MediaTek Android phone firmware using Miracle.